हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर द न्यू वीडियो। द ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट ऑक्सीजन। ऑक्सीजन बाय इटसेल्फ इज नॉट यूज्ड एन ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट, हाउएवर इट इज यूज्ड फॉर वेरियस ऑक्सीडेशंस इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ सर्टेन कैटलिस्ट्स। इट इज यूज्ड मोस्टली फॉर द इंडस्ट्रियल प्रिपरेशन ऑफ नंबर ऑफ इम्पोर्टेंट प्रोडक्ट्स। व्हाट आर दोज इम्पोर्टेंट इंडस्ट्रियल प्रोडक्ट्स विच वी कैन ऑब्टेन बाय दिस ऑक्सीजन इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ कैटलिस्ट। वी विल लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द एग्जाम्पल। मिथाइल अल्कोहल विच कैन बी ऑब्टेन्ड फ्रॉम मीथेन, मीथेन ऑन ऑक्सीडेशन विथ दिस ऑक्सीजन अंडर कैटलिस्ट कॉपर कैटलिस्ट at 100 atmospheric pressure and 260 degree temperature. In this way we can synthesize methyl alcohol, that is methanol. The ratio of methane and oxygen here 9:1. The next method is formaldehyde, which can be obtained from methane, which on oxidation with oxygen, the controlled oxidation condition is molybdenum oxide and 400 degree centigrade temperature, it is high temperature and 200 atmospheric pressure. In this condition we can synthesize formaldehyde with the elimination of one mole of water molecule. And the next method is acetaldehyde, CH3CHO, which can be synthesized by ethanol in presence of Ag, here is an oxygen at 250 degree centigrade temperature, or you can use the condition copper with a 300 degree centigrade temperature. This ethylene can be oxidized with oxygen, oxidized in presence of palladium catalyst, palladium chloride and CuCl, copper chloride, which gives ethanol, that is acetaldehyde, NaL, that is aldehyde, ethanol acetaldehyde. This process is known as Walker's process. This is a very important process because in the previous NET exam this question has asked in the ethylene how you can oxidize by using palladium chloride and copper chloride, which we can obtain ethanol. Here these two catalysts are very important, you should remember this palladium chloride and copper chloride. This process is called as Walker's process. And the next preparation is benzaldehyde can be obtained the toluene on oxidation in presence of MnO2, molybdenum trioxide and zirconium oxide at 500 degree centigrade temperature. This is one of the industrial method. And phthalic anhydride, which can be obtained naphthalene on oxidation with oxygen in presence of vanadium pentoxide at 500 degree temperature, which gives phthalic anhydride. Furic acid, which can be obtained from furfural with oxygen in presence of Ag2O. Maleic acid can be synthesized by using this benzene as a starting material. Benzene on oxidation in presence of vanadium pentoxide with 400 to 500 degree centigrade temperature, which gives intermediate maleic anhydride, which further heating with water gives maleic acid. Here the intermediate step is maleic anhydride. Maleic anhydride which on heating with water which gives maleic acid. These are the some important industrial preparation method of this various important compounds by using oxygen as an oxidizing agent with in presence of catalyst. And here alkene can be converted into allylic alcohol with the oxygen as an oxidizing agent. And this oxygen is adding here across this double bond. In case of alkene, it should have a double bond. Across this double bond, oxygen we are adding, and this oxygen which is having a pi electron which abstract this proton, and this double bond is shifting, this bond is shifting towards carbon and carbon, and this double bond is which is attacking to oxygen, and hence we are getting here hydroperoxide. This is a intermediate step, hydroperoxide, whatever we are getting, this is a intermediate step which on reduction here elimination of oxygen takes place, and we will get here allylic alcohol. We are removing one of the oxygen atom, hence it is a reduction process. We are getting here allylic alcohols. In case of cyclic conjugated dienes, the reaction is believed to proceed as in the case of Diels-Alder reaction. In the case of Diels-Alder reaction also, we have used this oxygen as an oxidizing agent. How oxygen will be adding across the double bond in case of cyclic conjugated dienes? Here the oxygen is adding across this double bond. In this way, here one of the double bond, across this double bond oxygen is adding. See here, oxygen is adding across this double bond, and this double bond is remains as it is, or this double bond is shifting towards these two carbon atoms, and oxygen is adding like this between this and this carbon atom. Oxygen is adding, and this double bond is shifting here, and across this double bond oxygen is adding. These two are the intermediate step. In this way, this is a cyclic process. The oxygen is adding either this double bond or this double bond is shifting here, and it will be attacking to the double bond. This is a in case of Diels-Alder reaction also, you can use it like this. Here alpha phenin can be converted into trans pinocarbiol. This is the structure of alpha phenin. Here one double bond is there. Across this double bond we are adding oxygen. See, this pi electron which abstract the proton which is present in this carbon atom, and this bond is shifting towards these two carbon atoms, and these pi electrons which is attacking to the oxygen, and these pi electrons already abstracting this proton, hence here electron deficient, hence it is abstracting this double bond, that is pi electrons. This is the intermediate step. We are getting here trans pinocarbiol hydroperoxide. This is the intermediate step, and which on reduction gives trans pinocarbiol. One of the oxygen we are eliminating. In the presence of sodium Na2SO3 and aqueous methanol here used as a condition. Here across this double bond we are adding oxygen, and we are getting alcoholic group, that is OH group. This is the starting material 2-methyl-2-pentene, which on oxidation the oxygen will be adding across this double bond. Here one of the hydrogen which is abstracted by this pi electrons, and this bond is shifting towards these carbon atoms, and the pi electrons which are attacking to the oxygen, and here we are getting double bond. After shifting this double bond we are getting double bond, and here OOH, this OO and this is a H, we are getting here OOH, which further reduction takes place. One of the oxygen we have to remove here because it is a reduction step, and this is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. At the third position this OH group will be attacking here, and in the same way we have two protons. One proton is here and one more proton is here. Here also one proton and here also one proton. It can abstract this proton or this proton. One more step, there are two methods here. By the elimination of this proton we got this product. At third position OH group will be attacked, and if it will abstract this proton, what happens here? By abstracting this proton, this bond is shifting towards these two carbon atoms, and these pi electrons are attacking on the oxygen atom. Hence, we are getting per acid, that is OOH group, at this position, that the second position, which on reduction gives alcohol, that is OH group. We are removing here one of the oxygen atom. Here the alcoholic group, that is OH group, is attacking to the second position, but here it was attacked at third position. By abstracting this proton, we got here OH group at the third position. By abstracting this proton, we got here the OH group at the second position. These two mixtures we got here, and these two mixtures are in the 1:1 ratio, that is methyl pentenols. These are called methyl pentenols. These two are in the 1:1 ratio. Thank you for watching this video.